been a while, I'm sure, since the All Blacks fielded a second row combination with 10 caps between them. What gives you the confidence that these two are ready to play a test match together?
Well, they've played a lot of rugby together, Elliot, when you look at, you know, through Taranaki and age group stuff and also their time in the Chiefs. I think there's two different players here. And so, you know, look at Tupou Vaia. He's been with us from last year through to this year. Every challenge we've given him, we've been really confident that he's been able to nail it. So, you know, I think he's a growing force. He's learning to really trust himself and just express himself on the park. And we've seen very similar qualities in Josh since he's come in. You know, he's a different frame and a slightly different style look, but very energetic, very mobile. And I just love his attitude. He's just come in, he's spoke his mind, he's contributed, he's asked questions, and, you know, we're delighted to be able to give him a start.
And in terms of the last two matches, do you have an idea in mind for your 23s? I guess the question, I mean, how many places are up for grabs as you look into the last two matches of the tour this weekend?
Look, we went into this Northern Hemisphere tour with sort of a three-game plan, and this is the third game, obviously. And after that, you know, we know that we've got Ireland and France waiting, and, you know, as a group of selectors, we've got a pretty clear plan for Ireland. But, you know, I'd be pretty surprised if there weren't a number of players that start on Saturday that aren't starting in one of the next two tests.
What have you seen from Sammy Cane and Dane Coles, I suppose, over the last couple of weeks in their return to rugby that gives you the confidence to put them out there and start this weekend?
Oh, just massive desire to play for this team. You know, they both love the jersey a lot. They've been away. Sometimes when you're away, you sort of, it can reignite a bit of passion for the team and to be part of it. And I've certainly seen that with both those two coming back in. So we've had to bide our time, because whilst we have got a lot of faith in both those players, it's, you know, a significant length of time away, but trained well, enthusiastic, and, you know, running around like anything at training today. So, you know, pretty excited about about seeing them play on Saturday.
For Sammy Cane in particular, he's had quite a bit of time away from rugby with that injury. Were you always comfortable handing him back the captaincy as well as his first start in the All Blacks for the year?
Yeah, well, I've got a lot of faith in him from a captaincy perspective. I think that's been pretty obvious over the last couple of years. I think in this case, it's, you know, we haven't, I think we said that, you know, we weren't in a hurry to rush him back into the captaincy thing. We wanted him to come back in, but the way the selections worked out for this group, it's, you know, we really felt it was right. We wanted to give Sammy Whitelock a little bit less time. Brody's shoulder, whilst it's really good, we didn't want to use him in this game. And Artie, well, he had a monstrous game last week and really feel he's better having a rest. So I think the captaincy sits really easily on Sam's shoulder. And so in some ways, I think it's probably just going to sharpen his preparation for this week.
Just on Richie Mo'unga starting for you at 10 this weekend, I mean, it's a different position for him, and I know, you know, a lot of that was to do with circumstances. Just how have you seen him, you know, on since he's rejoined you, and, you know, what's your sense and how he's tackling this challenge and obviously his opportunity this week?
Yeah, look, he's been great, and it's, you know, like he's, you know, I mean, we're excited for him and his family with the birth of a baby. And so the circumstances that have, you know, the cards have been dealt in that space. And so he's come back in and he's been phenomenal. You know, I was massively impressed with him last week when it was, you know, it became a little bit of the Bodie show, didn't it, with 100 tests and that. But Richie's support and behind the scenes was phenomenal. So, and so I'm delighted he's about to play, and I'm sure he's going to play to his normal levels, if not even better. He's very determined. He's, you know, though, everyone's competitive, and he's like everyone else. So, and he'll certainly be eyeing up some time in the next couple of weeks as well. So, we've been really pleased with him and liked what he brought off the bench. And now I know that he's, you know, he's back in the groove with us 100%. I'm looking forward to seeing him start.
Thanks, Foz. And just, you know, on the theme, I guess, of the depth you're developing on this tour, and it's been a, you know, one of the real ticks, I'm sure, for you. Just your young midfielders, we spoke to them a bit earlier today. They're obviously very excited about their chance. You know, how excited are you about, I guess, the long-term potential they offer?
Yeah, look, I'm very optimistic. They, you know, both Quinn and Braden, I think, growing through this tour, they look very settled. I think they're, you know, I'll use the word comfortable, not that anyone can really be comfortable here, but they seem to be really confident in themselves. They, I thought this week their training was up two cogs from what it was in the USA week. And so I think they've banked away a lot of confidence from that game, and they know this is going to be a much bigger challenge. But I think they sort of see opportunities. They know it's a big occasion for them, and delighted for them. But they bring their own little strengths, and you know, we've got a strong ball carrier and a great defender, and we've got a guy who's a equally good defender, but also very, very quick in the way he attacks. So there's a nice blend there, and can't wait to see it develop.
Ian, I have two questions for you. First of all, I would like to know, presumably, like, you know, Kieran Crowley quite well. He's a Kiwi. You've seen him, how he's coaching Canada and Benetton. What type of Italy are you expecting to see tomorrow on Saturday?
I don't know. I think in many ways, Kieran probably hasn't had a lot of time to put his mark on the team. He's... But we do know he's rock solid in how he prepares it. I know his foundation work with Treviso has been about growing the self-reliance of the players and involving them in the decision-making. And I think he clearly got them in a really good space. And I'm assuming that he'll be trying to do the same thing with the Italian national team. So, you know, it doesn't happen overnight internationally. And so... But, you know, I certainly see a team that won't lack in passion and will probably be trying to focus really hard on the basics of the game. And it'll be interesting to see whether they maybe play a little bit more through their traditional methods of their forwards and try to bring that part of their game back stronger, or whether they try to play a really open game. So we're guessing a little bit.
What do you think about Paulino Garbisi, this young guy, 21 years old, is now transferred from Benetton to Montpellier? You see footage. Once again, what do you think about him?
Look, I haven't seen a lot of him, but we've been very impressed with what we do see, you know. And, you know, Italy's had, you know, quite a number of young teens come through in the last 7-8 years. You look at Tomasi Allen and Kana, you've got a few guys that have come through that almost want to express themselves really, really well, and they don't seem to lack confidence when they get on the international stage. And so we kind of see those same qualities. So we'll see, you know, we're very watchful of that. And so whilst a young man who's impressed us, we also want to make sure we pull out a bit of pressure there too.